and welcome back to another edition of the CEO's Blog. John, some exciting times. We had the opening of Riverina Paceway on Sunday in Wagga Wagga.
And what an opening it was. Build it and they will come, and they certainly did. The crowd estimated around 3,500 people, and they enjoyed a wonderful day of racing, but most of all they enjoyed a magnificent facility. So all credit to the club for what they did to put that meeting together, all credit to the Board of Harness Racing New South Wales and the several boards of Harness Racing New South Wales for seeing this project all the way through to what is a great grand opening.
Well, it's been a long road, hasn't it? It's been quite a few years in the making to get to this point.
Oh, it certainly has. For me, some sleepless nights. For others, more sleepless nights. But no, great result. A little bit more to do there, but it will be better. We've built it in the middle of a drought. There's benefits in that, but the club will put together the landscaping. Still has to come in. We still have to have approval for the night meetings. The lighting is superb. We've had it on, but there's just a couple of things to do.
Well, Harness Racing New South Wales Chairman Rod Smith rarely misses a major meeting here in New South Wales, and he was definitely there at Wagga on Sunday, and he had a special announcement regarding the Alaba Breeders' Challenge.
Certainly did, and rarely is not the right word. He never misses a major meeting, but Rod, on behalf of the board, announced the regional finals will be conducted at Wagga on Sunday, August the 4th. Now, this is as a result of some survey work we did late last year on the Breeders' Challenge. So the regional finals will now move from place to place. So that announcement's been made, but what he also announced, that those regional finals will go from $30,000 to $50,000 races. So it's a boost in prize money, it's a sharing arrangement. They'll go between the three regions, the Hunter, the West and the Riverina, over the rotation, and that's all good. And this week in the mail, all participants with eligible horses will receive that news. And also, I must reiterate that those four $100,000 races are on in Wagga next April. So all that information will go out there, and it'll be, fantastic racing in the Riverina.
Yeah, plenty to look forward to. Well, there was a lot of people there on track on Sunday, as you just mentioned, with the crowd. So they've got a few feature meetings to look forward to. One driver that could be there, John, come September is Hannah Rickson, who's making her debut this week.
Yeah, Penrith, interesting facts here. A.D. Turnbull, the legendary A.D. Turnbull, 12th grandchild of 12 to drive in races, and there are only 12, as I say. Hannah will be competing against a brother, Will, and a sister as well. So, it's all about Hannah, I suppose, on Thursday at Penrith.
Yeah, and I look forward to it. I'm sure her mum, Cindy, she had to race against her siblings when she first started, and even her dad.
Yeah, well, that's right. And Cindy was the best of the drivers, of course. I was talking to her earlier in the stables. She said there's a fair bit of sibling rivalry, as it is, with Ellen as well. But I think the two girls, they'll outdo Will for a little while.
Oh, well, there you go. All right, Will, hope you're watching. All right, John. On Carnival of Cups, we've got plenty on this weekend, starting with Broken Hill Young, then Inverell.
Yes, special meeting at Broken Hill. The only TAB meeting each year. There's six races there. Interestingly, the nominations, like most of the other Carnival Cups meetings, are stronger than they were the previous year. So that's Broken Hill Friday night. Of course, Young is on the next night, and it's a very strong program. Always there's horses from Sydney that go down for that, and then it's Inverell on Sunday. But one person that I can tell you, I'll be at two of those meetings, but our chairman, Rod Smith, will be at all three. So as usual, if somebody out there in the country areas wish to talk to us about where harness racing's going and any suggestions, come and approach us, and we'll see what we can take back to the board.
Yes. Most definitely. Okay, John, on the weekend, also at Wagga on Sunday, was the last meeting here in New South Wales where we had Team Teal for 2019.
And what a great effort. A tick over $40,000 was raised in New South Wales for Team Teal, for research into ovarian cancer. So I thank everybody that participated, all the girls that drove in the races, the clubs that supported it so strongly, and all those other people that made special donations. $40,000 might not seem a lot of money, but it is a significant amount of money when we're talking about research into this insidious cancer that affects so many of us. Whether we're male or female, it certainly affects us. So thank you very much, and we'll look forward again to next year's Team Teal promotion.
Yeah, most definitely. I think we raised at least over $10,000 more than what we did last year with our final figure, and there's still more money to roll in. So a fantastic effort by all.
Fancy. And I must make special mention to Kate and all those cupcakes. Whoever purchased a cupcake, well, you were the beneficiaries there, but that was a big effort. As far as I know, there was over $1,000 just raised out of a gold coin donations for the cupcake. So well done.
All right, John, big edition of the blog. Thank you for your time.
Pleasure, Amanda.
And we'll look forward to next week's edition.
Thank you.